All right, well, tell you what, I am on a mission. If you watched my last live stream, I went and found all the gold nuggets. On this version that I use for doing just regular videos, I haven't done that, and I need some money because I want to buy some fields. And that's what I did in the live stream. I got all the gold nuggets, I got my $1 million, and I bought several fields. I want to do that here too, so I'm going to start with this one. I think this was be my 10th one. If you look at my map, I don't see any. So if I pick this one up, it should fill my map up, which it did. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go around and find all of these, and I'll come back and do some farming. Well, we are back, and if you look at the map here, I've got one left to get, and there it is right there. All right, we have $1 million. Okay, so I'm going to probably end up buying the same fields I bought in the live stream, because I'm trying to keep a certain amount of fields down here on the bottom side of the canal and a certain amount on the other side. So let me buy this one over yonder, this one right here, 28. Let's buy that one. We got a field full of hops. Cool beans. And then let's run across the river here. Canal. It's not a river. We're going to run up this way. And let's see. This is 7. Let's buy 7. All right, let's go buy 12, which has nothing on it. What do they want us to do? I tell you what, before we buy 12, let's work it and put some crops on it. And then let's see how much 13 is. All right, and then we'll take this one also. Okay, so we have a little bit of money left. Let's do the mission on this. This is. We'll do a couple missions on here. It should bring the price down, and everything. So let's do that. Oh, this stupid weight. It's one of them that you got to go around backwards to put on. I'm going to take all my time just putting this stupid weight on. Couldn't give me a tractor. It already had a weight on it. I know. I'm whining. I like to whine, though. It's fun. If you're going to whine, at least enjoy it. You know what I mean? I'm wasting all my time. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hook up, hook up. There we go. Okay, barley. They want us to plant. Well, I can use barley. Let's put this thing down. Get up here. Don't go off of the reservation. And all right, here we go. We're going to start right here. And tell you what, I'm going to put this on. We don't need the offset. Let's do that and that there, and turn that on. Let's go for it. See how this does. Okay, I've only got 15 minutes left. I gotta hustle. Took me a half hour to just put the stupid stuff on there. Bad part about doing missions when I'm using the GPS, I can't stop. I can't leave this piece of equipment. If I do, I fail the mission. So we're forced to sit here and watch me. You're forced to sit here and watch me farm. Isn't that awful? Tell you what, though. I can always get me a glass of water while I'm waiting. The soup du jour today is...
water.
Yuck. I could put something in it, I guess. I'll put some peach tea flavor in it. If I have some here, I think I do. I usually have Snapple laying around, but my little box just went empty last night. And... pop this one open. This is also, I like the Snapple peach tea flavored, and I use that. It's a little packet you put in a bottle of water, and it makes it taste like Snapple. Well, this stuff I get from the grocery store, and it's just peach tea flavor. Same thing, only it doesn't quite taste like Snapple. As a matter of fact, the peach flavoring is actually more peachy than the Snapple one. So it's pretty good. The only problem is, when you get used to one, which is the Snapple, then the other one, being more peachy, kind of tastes different. So, even though it's a peachier taste, it's almost too much. Yeah, I know. How could you ever have too much of a good thing, huh? But it does happen. I like Oreo cookies. Okay, but my favorite ones are the vanilla Oreo cookies. I like both, but the vanilla I like a little better. So I get the double stuff because, hey, twice as much of the creamy stuff on the inside is better, right? Okay, so I went to the store one day and I saw that they had triple stuff. Ooh, more is better. So I thought. And I bought them, and they were too much. It was too much. It was too sweet. I couldn't eat them like I normally do. Normally, I'll grab, you know, two, maybe three cookies, and I'll eat them. And then a couple of days go by, maybe I'll have another one or two. I don't eat a lot of that stuff. I don't sit and eat the whole bag. I couldn't. You know, I'm diabetic. I can't eat that kind of stuff. But occasionally, if I know I'm going to sit on the treadmill for a half hour, 45 minutes, you know, I might go ahead and have a cookie or two, wait an hour or so, and then do my exercise. Kind of do that kind of thing. But the triple stuff, in which I thought more was better, turned out not to be. It was actually too much. Now, it could be the fact that I'm just used to eating the double-stuffed cookies, and I like them, and I just wasn't used to the triple stuff. What is that on the ground? I can't stomp and look or I'll fail my mission. I don't want to fail. Now what I'm going to have to do probably is wait until the next mission. I don't know how long that will take. If you hear a weird noise, It's me shaking up the drink, the water. I'm shaking the bottle of water. Shake, 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 shake. Shake that water. I gotta be careful. As Chris Kimball knows, and if you don't know who Chris Kimball is, he does YouTube videos on farming. Check him out. He does a good job. But anyway, as he knows, you gotta be careful when you're drinking stuff on a computer. he spilled soda on his computer and blew it up, and he had to buy a new laptop. So you got to be careful with that kind of thing. Make sure that the lid is on tight. Don't shake it too strongly. I'm about done shaking this one, I think. And I actually shouldn't have that kind of a problem anyway, because my computers are a mile away from where I'm sitting. My computers are all way away from me. One of them is probably about 4 feet away, under a table. I couldn't spill anything on them if I wanted to. I might spill something on the keyboard, but I've got 4 or 5 keyboards sitting around here. So, no big deal. If I lose a keyboard, I lose a keyboard. Well, it is a big deal, but I've got spares, what I'm trying to say. This particular keyboard I'm using is a Corsair. It's a gaming computer, a keyboard. It's mechanical, so at times if you hear me typing, you can really hear me typing, because it's a mechanical keyboard. But it's a gaming keyboard, and the keys being built the way they are very, they're real sensitive, so you can type really fast. You can, you know, it's really responsive, I should say, and it does a pretty good job. And of course, they're backlit, so they're really brightly backlit. I'm getting close. This should do it right here. Hey. Okay, so I got about $8,000, a little close to eight and a half, and that should bring the price of the field down a little bit. And I think what I'll do, though, is, okay, why does it want me to do that? Okay, it wants me to fertilize already. Well, let's do it. Let's do it. Sorry about this, but I'm trying to buy this field. Oh, it's the same stupid equipment. This one shouldn't take as long as the seeding. This spray rig should move pretty quickly. Okay, don't get too far away. Why'd I do that? That was silly. Oh, nice time to save the game. All right, let's get this thing spread out. I hope it spreads out fairly wide so it doesn't take as long as the seeding did. Actually, the seeding didn't take that long, really, but this should take less time. All right, let's get this party started. Oh, wow. I could do much wider. I started off kind of bad, didn't I? I'm going to leave it at this. It'll be okay in the long run. Trust me, I'm a professional. I'm not a farmer, but I play one on YouTube. You can remember those actors coming out. I'm not a doctor, but I play one on TV. And I'm here to tell you about the latest new suppository. Like, we're supposed to believe an actor on medical care. I mean, really, just because he plays a doctor on TV. And then you trust them to tell you how to vote? That's crazy. I can appreciate actors for their talent in pretending to be somebody they're not. You know, they're basically pretty good liars. Fibbers. They're, you know, and some actors don't watch their own movies. But imagine this, though. They're playing a Western, or maybe not a Western, but they're playing in a show, and what you don't see when they're sitting on a horse is they're sitting on a stuffed horse pretending to bounce up and down, or they're sitting in a car that's not moving and they have a film running behind them. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff that you'd feel kind of silly at if that was your job. But they do it very well. Some of them are very good at it, pretending to be somebody they're not. And they don't, they can't necessarily do what you and I do every day for a living. So they pretend to be somebody they're not. And again, I appreciate their talent. And I go to their movies and I provide the money, you know, by paying for the costs of the theaters and the popcorn, all that stuff. I'm providing them a living by watching their movies, and I don't have a problem with that. But that doesn't mean they're smarter than me and can tell me how to vote and what kind of pills to buy and, you know, all that kind of stuff. But some people think that they're, you know, extra special, I guess. I don't happen to be one of them. We had a lot of movies in this area made. Arnold Schwarzenegger made Kindergarten Cop here. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movies were made here, a couple of them. Free Willy was made here. The Goonies was made here. Short Circuit was made here. There's just a lot of different movies have been made here where I live. And I've had opportunities to go and see actors and stuff. I never have. People said, "Oh, haven't you gone to see Arnold?" I said, "Why? I pay money to see him in the theater. I don't have to go out of my way on my free time." I know it's a little cynical, isn't it? Okay, so that's it. I'm done with this. I think what I'm gonna do is this is seeded and fertilized. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and buy it. I got the price down a little bit. Let's go ahead and buy it. And we still have a half a million left. And let's go do some dang farming. Tell you what. I'm tired of doing missions already. Can I jump that? No, I can't. Darn it. There's a gate here. Right, let's look around and see what we have to do. Oh, by the way, let me show you what I've got here. I have a new cedar that I bought. Where's the store? Did I miss the store? There you go. All right, look at this monster. Look at this guy. I found this on Mod Hub. And I kind of miss my air cedar. I used to use a John Deere air cedar, if you remember, in 2015. And this is similar to it, except for it's backwards. The seed cart usually was in the front on the John Deere. On this case one, they've got it in the back. And I'm not entirely sure what the deal is, because the seeds are put in here, and so is the fertilizer, but then what's the tank for? But anyway, I'll show it to you when we go to work next time. I got my tanker here, and look what I have back. I have the old Red Baron back. There it is, the old Red Baron. So let's grab the old Red Baron. And let's grab the new cedar. And I don't know if I have any fields that need seeding. Let's take a look, because I don't remember what I was doing. But let's see. Okay, there's the fruit types. That's not what I want, though. I want to see the growth pattern. Okay, look, 31, we just... Okay, I got to go find out what's going on, because that doesn't look like it's all the way done, 32. And 31 is harvested and needs to be seeded. Oh, I don't own 15. I need to buy 15 while I still have a little bit of money left. All right, well, let's get this thing down on the other side of the canal and put it to use, because 31 is a fairly good sized field. So let's do that. Isn't this thing a monster? Look at that. My goodness. I don't know if I can get it down that road. I'm going to take it down this one. This road's... Oh, these articulated tractors. This road's a little bit wider. Let me get out of here before that guy hits me. Looks like I lost a little bit on the end of that field. And let's see if we can get over these bridges okay. Now, probably still keep Pigpen. Pigpen's been faithful to me. I don't know. We'll see. Pigpen still does a good job, but let's see what kind of job this thing does. This might be the one I get rid of. I don't know. Haven't really used it yet. Oh, geez. Be careful. Wow, it just barely fits on this bridge. Oh, I see what's going on. All right. I see. You know what I forgot to do? Forgot to put seed in, didn't I? Okay, I was using this little booger. And I was doing corn. Really? I was doing corn? Oh, yeah. Let's finish this out. All right, I hired somebody. Who'd I hire? Wiry. You go do that, Wiry. In the meantime, I got something else to show you. I need to get this guy down there, so let's do that. But let me go this way, and I'll show you what it is I'm going to show you. All right, so I got a couple more mods. Here's one of them here. Now, this mod right here is a mixing station. And if you remember, I had a silo that I left in this area, and I told you I was going to keep this clear just in case I needed to put the hayloft in again. I don't think I'm going to need the hayloft, so I decided to give this a try. Now, this thing holds a total of, when it's done, 150,000 units of mixed feed. And Scorpion showed me this. He's been using it for quite some time. And he gave it to me, I can't remember how long ago, and I haven't even put it in my mod folder yet. So I went ahead and put it in the mod folder, and I thought I'd give it a try here. So if you look this, though, I can bring my tractors through here and feed it or fill it right here. And then there's a spout right there. So what I did was I lined the spout up so that I can drive through like this and pick up this mixed feed and then run it right over this and dump it. Pretty cool, huh? And so let's see. Gosh, all kinds of new mods. I got the old Red Baron back. I got a new seeder. I've got a mixing station. I do have another one that is another placeable. And we got it because this farm in the north and the south, there's no place to get fuel, really. So I got this little thing. It's very small, and it's got its own lamp on it. So it's got a light on it for at nighttime. It's only $5,000, well, $6,000. But it's very small. It's just a fuel pump, is all it is. And you can place it anywhere you want. So I got that going. So let's head out. I found some issues with the map. I can't figure it out. I haven't been able to get it figured out. This area right here is supposed to be a place where if you drive up right here, you can put your solid poo, and this area right here is also for liquid poo. You're supposed to be able to store it here. Then when you drive under this conveyor belt, it will ask you if you want manure liquid or manure solid. The problem is there's also a trigger right here. This trigger doesn't work. So we can't figure out how to get the liquid manure out of here. Because when you pull a trailer that has a tank on it, it won't let you have it. So I haven't figured that out yet. I went in GE Editor and I looked at it, and I didn't see anything wrong with it. There is an actual pipe buried under the ground here. I don't know. I'm still working on trying to figure it out. Woo! There went the sunflower seeds. If I get it figured out, fine. If I don't, I usually don't store manure and slurry anyway. So I don't know if it's going to be a problem or not. All right, let's see if this works. Red Baron. Okay, there goes that. I don't want potatoes, though. Let's do corn. And then let's see about see if I have to put this on the other side. Now, see, the seeds go in the actual seed, a sewing machine. They don't go in the tank. So I don't know what the tank is for. Because I pulled the tank up and it wouldn't take anything. So I have no idea if the tank is just for looks or what. That was the good thing about the one that I used to use in 15. It actually worked like it was supposed to. All right, let me find that and let's put this in 6, I think. Yeah, 6. We'll put that in there. Let's get this thing lined up. Open it up. Good to have Red Baron back. I like the Red Baron. It's a muscle car of tractors. And you would expect a tractor this size, that you'd need one for this size of a cedar. Look at this monster. This thing is truly a monster. All right, so we got it set on corn. Let's hire a worker and see how this goes. All right, so Dar, I've got, one of my farmer's daughters is driving this monster machine. Cool. So let's go check on the other cedar and see if he needed some help, which he does. So let's finish this up. This field's going to be kind of messed up because it took me so long to get everything seeded here. I'm reseeding over some of it. I got tired of picking up straw, so I just decided to plant right over the top of the straw. I don't think I meant to do that. I didn't mean to do that. Well, the growth pattern on this is going to be a little ugly, but if I don't come down here for a while, it'll be okay. All right, so we're done with this. Let's see what else we need to have done. Okay, Dar's working on that. 32's done. 28 we just bought needs to be harvested. 43 is done. Let's go buy 15 and get that over with, and we'll get a combine and come down and get the hops off of 28 and then reseed 28. I'm going to leave the Red Baron to it. Dar will take care of that field. Let's get Pigpen out of here. Okay, just information. Pigpen, for some reason, rides a little low in the tail. If you take these bridges right in the middle, like where the stripe line is, he gets hung up. So if you notice, there's a curb right to the right and over here to the left. I drive up on the curb, which lifts up the ass end of Pigpen, and I don't get stuck. I've gotten stuck there several times where I've had to get into ramming speed. All right, let's tuck this thing in here. I don't know where I'm going to put the Red Baron and that new cedar. That new cedar, geez, just a monster. All right, we'll just tuck him in there nice and tidy. What else we got? Oh, hey, yeah, we've got to do a combine. Give me a combine. Oh, there's already a combine down here. Sweet. I think. Yeah. Cool. Corn's coming up already. Now, hopefully, I'll be able to hire a worker on these fields. Some of the fields are kind of strange. The new ones that I just bought, 7 and 12, they're a little bit weird. You hire somebody, and they'll go to the end of the field and stop. And I think the reason is the road, the cement road, is messing them up somehow. All right, let me see if we can get this hired worker to work here. Let's hire somebody and let them do these hops. Who do we have working? Lee. Lee's working today. So let's see what else we got here. What do we got going? I'll tell you what. Oh, Dar's done. Really? Well, how'd she do? Looks like she did well. So we'll run Dar down here and get her ready to work the next field here once the hops are off of it. We'll just park Dar right here. There you go, Red Baron. Stay there. Don't move. What? Oh, missed a little bit. Okay, now what else would I need to do? This is not the one I want. This one. Let's work this one. No, wait a minute. I might need the big one. Let's try the big one. Okay, so I'm going to fill up that mixing station. Now, here's the difference. The mixing station for the... No, wait a minute. That's right. This is just mixed rations. All right, so we need straw. Let's get some straw. Let that fill. And I want to go, oh, okay, I tell you, I wanted to go buy that other field. So I have, I didn't buy the one right in the middle, is why I want to buy that field. It's not very big, doesn't cost very much money. Right here, this one, I didn't buy this one. And no, I don't want you to harvest it. I want to harvest it myself. Now, that will give me all of these fields, 7, 12, and 13, 8, 9, 10, 14, 15 is the one I didn't have, 16, then I've got 28, 31, 32, and 43. That should keep me busy for quite some time until I can make a little bit of money. I've said this before, but I haven't been selling many of my crops. I've been just selling compost to make money. All right, let's see. Let me get the other combine, get rid of the corn header, and see if I can figure out where I put my other header. Got an issue with my hard drive, my main hard drive that I've got. I've got a... I've got an SSD card, and when I put the computer together, the guy that sold me parts and stuff said, listen, you don't need a real big SSD card because all you want to run on it is your hard drive. It's your operating system, Windows. And I said, yeah, okay. So what are you suggesting? Well, you should only need like 150 or so. And so that's what I bought. Well, actually not. I bought a 250. Because I didn't necessarily believe him. Now, where's my... Do I have to go in here and look? Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Where's my header? All right, let's go find it. So anyway, I didn't believe him necessarily. I put a 250 in. Well, after a year now or so, that 250 is... getting full. It's in the red. And I actually haven't put anything on it, but it's Windows. What does Windows do? Windows updates, and they add stuff, and they try to do things to make it easier for you. So they put a bunch of stuff in your hard drive that who knows whether it's necessary or not, and it just clutters it up. So now my hard drive is so cluttered, it's starting to affect the way my games play. I don't know where my header is. What? All right, let me see if I can find it. Doggone it. So I bought a new SSD card. I bought a 500 gig. And I bought a new version of Windows 10. Because I had Windows 7 on this computer, and I updated it when Windows 10 said they'd give me a free copy. And at the time, I thought it was a mistake, but I've gotten used to Windows 10, and it does seem to be working fairly well. So, I don't know what to do. Let me see. Okay. Where is it? Where is it? That's the... Okay. Where's the other one? Okay, there's that one. I think... Oh, man. Okay, there it is. There it is, right there. Up by the whatchadinger. What's it doing over there? Let's reset it. That was crazy. What was it doing over there? Must have been where I stored it. I'm not going to go back and watch the last video to find out why I put it there. All right, let's just go to work. Anyway, make a long story longer. I'm going to go ahead and put that new hard drive in. But what I'm trying to figure out, though, is I still have the ability to reload the Windows 7 that I had with this computer. And I'm debating whether to go back to Windows 7 and then keep the Windows 10 for some other purpose. Because all my computers have Windows 10 on it now. I just don't know what to do. Now, Frankenstein computer does not have an SSD drive in it at all. So here's the other solution that might be viable. And that it... Did I not plant this? Oh, I had potatoes on this. This needs to be planted. What? It sure does. It's purple, which means it's harvested. Oh, all right. Fine. I got to get one of those things back. My other solution is to take the SSD card that's in this computer I'm running right now, put it in the Frankenstein computer, and use the Windows 7 to wipe it out and reload Windows on it. I don't know. Thinking. I just don't know what to do. That might work. Now I got everybody confused. What the hell are you talking about? Nothing. Never mind. I guess it'd help if it unfolded the combine, wouldn't it? All right, I don't think it'll do me any good to hire somebody on this edge because of those trees. I think it's going to... Well, I can try. Let's hire somebody. All right, Ryan Kennedy's on the job. Let's see if he can figure out what to do with these trees. Let me go check on... Oh, almost... Oh, wow. Oh, goodness. Another strangely shaped field. Coming right down, though. Let's see. I need to get that other cedar. All right. Let's take Pigpen out. And let me see what I have planted. We have fruit types. What do we have? Get out of that. All right, so everything has 17. Okay, it looks like I had sunflower seeds up here and corn down here. That's right. I did that so that I could... what am I planting here now, though? What's Ryan planting? Nothing yet. Okay, I did that. I remember I did that. I did that because the sunflowers and the corn both need the corn header. So I didn't have to worry about hauling headers around. So let's do sunflowers. Up here. Wow. I'm not getting much done. Right, looks like Ryan, he's not done. He thinks he is. All right, we're going to do sunflowers here. And how are we going to do this? This is going to be a mess. All right, let me do it this way. Why is he stopped there? They seem to stop on that road for some... Oh, I wonder if there was a car there. All right. Oh, shoot. Oh, look what I just did. Dang it. I'm trying to do a headland here. I believe I just did that. I could have waited until he was done harvesting, but I didn't. Can't seem to drive straight down these fields. Yeah, I know. Tell you something you don't know. I'm still having tons and tons and tons of fun on this map. Even though I'm finding a couple things wrong with it. Could be just me. Maybe I just don't know how to use those poo pits or something. I don't know. What the heck is that? Oh, I didn't put it down. Oh, silly, silly, silly. Darn it. Darn it. Darn it. All right, try this again. Okay, now let's see if we can get this thing cooking over here. Whoa! Alright, so... Uh-oh, they didn't like that. Try that again. Craig, what's the problem here? He doesn't want to do this. Why not? No, he really doesn't want to do this. Neither did John. All right, fine. By the time I forced him into doing it. Well, Daryl doesn't like doing it either, and neither does Bill. Okay, guys, you're letting me down. I don't know why. They just don't want to do it. I can't make any of them do it. Brian didn't even want to do it. Oh, it's Sunday. These guys don't work on Sunday. You want to bet? I just made that up. Wouldn't be surprised, though. Well, let's see if somebody will work this field. Okay, Dar, you're my girl. Do it. This field is long, but it's narrow. I'm going to do something a little different here. I'm going to go this way and get this out of the way. It's kind of weird, but it'll all eventually get seeded. Eventually. Okay, so this one's done, sunflowers. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode. Hope you had fun. If you did, give it a like, share it with a friend, subscribe if you haven't. And I'll see you on the farm in the next episode. Happy farming.